My name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra, and in this lesson, we're going to be talking about creating effect presets in Final Cut Pro 10. I have a project here that I shot with several different cameras, and one of the cameras is a top-down view that was shot in 4K. As you can see that I have lots of different clips through my timeline, and by creating a preset, I can create a solid group of effects that will always be consistent from shot to shot. So let's take a look at exactly what that would look like. I have a clip that has several different effects placed on here. I have a color board effect, a color curves effect, some contrast. I've actually flipped it. I've worked with the hue and saturation and a broadcast safe. Here's what my original clip looks like, and this is what it ends up looking like when I'm all complete. So you can see it's a pretty big difference, and what I eventually want to do is I want to take all the clips that are shot with this particular camera from this angle and apply these same effects to all of them all at once. The easiest way to do that is with a preset. And this is what we originally started with. So if I take this preset, I can drag that on here. And now that has placed all those different effects on there. So let's take a look at how that is created. Well, I'm going to start with just figuring out what I need to change. So in my case here, I know that I'm going to need to zoom this in. And this is originally shot in 4K and my timeline is 1080p. So I've got some latitude as far as how much I can zoom in. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom this in to right about here. Additionally, I'm going to go ahead and move this in the X position just a little bit. We'll take this up to about 150. Now I want to go ahead and add some color. In 10.4 and newer versions of Final Cut, we have several different ways we can color. We have our regular color board. Additionally, we have color wheels, curves, and hue and saturation. For my purposes right here, I'm just going to color balance this a little bit. Additionally, I'm going to come back down to basics, and I'm going to add a crisp contrast. I'm also going to add a broadcast safe. And for this particular scene, I want to also flip this. So I'm going to go ahead and add a flip. I feel pretty good about that. What I want to do is I want to make sure that this color board, this color curves, this crisp contrast, this flipped broadcast safe, and this transformation, I can bundle together in one effect. Now that I have all of these, I'm just going to click off of it and click onto the clip itself. And we're going to go to File, Save Video Effects Preset. And as soon as I click on that, it's going to ask me what attributes I want to save as part of this effect preset. I want all the different effects, and I want the transformation of the position and scale. Down here, we have some keyframe timing, and that's if we actually adjusted our keyframes over time. So as an example, if we were working with a color control that we wanted to go from something darker to light, and we had some keyframes on there, we can either stretch to fit those keyframes or maintain the timing depending on how long that clip is. For my purposes, I'm not working with any keyframes, and I'm just going to call this AV Ultra Effect Preset Demo, and I'm going to put it in my category of AV Ultra. You can see that you can specify specific different categories. I'm going to go ahead and hit save. But now that I have this preset, I can use this to place on multiple different clips all at once. Another way that I tend to use these presets is specifically for audio. Normally, when I record my tutorials, they actually sound like this. But by using some of these presets, I can place this on here. And since I'm using the same microphone every single time, my results are going to be consistent. So that's a basics of creating presets in Final Cut Pro 10 so you can make your shots uniform and even every single time. Again, my name is Stanislaw Robert Liberto with AV Ultra, and this has been all about creating presets in Final Cut Pro 10. Thanks a lot for watching, and hopefully you found this useful. I'll see you next time.